1984 has been an interesting and eventful year here in Bermuda, especially in the field of broadcasting. The strike and subsequent closure of the Bermuda Broadcasting Company brought almost complete silence to the local airwaves. East End residents, however, did have alternatives. Not only were they able to tune in to VSB, they could also pick up station MWK, Mohawk Radio, which transmitted more or less regularly from studios on Goat Spittle Lane in St. David's.
I see by the clock on the wall and the watch on my wrist that it's 7 o'clock. Time for the latest news here on station MWK, Mohawk Radio.
The sound of St. David's.
With the latest news from the Mohawk newsroom, here I am. Government announced today that because of financial problems, they will be unable to do follow-ups to the quality of life survey and the Royal Commission on Drug and Alcohol Abuse. In a cost-cutting move, government has decided to combine the two and do a quality of drug and alcohol survey. Enthusiastic response is expected. Police came close to intercepting a major drug shipment yesterday, but the dope ended up overboard. Police estimate a quarter of $1 million worth of cocaine was dumped over the side of the freighter Nasal Passage as she passed 8 miles off of St. David's. Meanwhile, local fisherman Eustace Squid Eyes Repose reports on marine activity in the area. Bream jumping 10 foot out of the water, sharks swimming backwards, and schools of white grunts blowing bubbles and singing, "I've got the munches for your love." We'll have more news after this word about House of Harold Fine Foods. When you think of seafood, you think of St. David's. And when you think of seafood, think of House of Harold, frozen seafood, entrees, and snacks. Just pop them in the oven and they're ready in minutes. Try delicious entrees like soft rocks on toast or scuttle surprise. And don't forget the kids, they'll love sea pudding pops, frozen fun on a stick. Remember the name, House of Harold, serving St. David's for a long time. And now back to the news. In traffic news, Irma Pitcher has failed her driving test again. This makes the 53rd time she's tried and failed to get her license. Irma said she was doing fine this time until she opened the door to let the clutch out. And St. David's taxi driver Philip Laidfoot O'Connor appeared in magistrate's court this week on speed charges. When asked whether he had any excuse, Laidfoot replied that his brakes had just failed and he was rushing to get home before he caused an accident. We'll have more news, plus the Mohawk AccuWeather forecast, and much, much more coming up here on station MWK.
The sound of St. David's.
Ruin! You lads have one last practical exam this afternoon. Before you graduate from this prestigious school, and go out on the street to become Bermuda taxi drivers. Now, I know you're all itching to get right out there and start living up to the great traditions of men like our old Snail's Pace Jackson and the great Tank Trot, who takes his car in every 2 weeks to have bits of moped picked out the tyres. But I'm here to remind you that for every tourist you successfully overcharge, there's 100 more out there waiting to get you. If you want to survive, you're going to have to keep a firm grip on your basics. Why are you clutching yourself for a faulty specimen?
Basics. My basics.
Driving basics, moron! Shut up! When's the best time to overtake?
On the flying corner.
Of course they blank. Keep it on, man.
That night with my high beams on.
Good boy. Nothing. What about blocking traffic? We all remember the legendary tadpole trigger. The man who blocked off the old East End by parking his taxi across the causeway. But for everyday driving, a good steady 15 miles an hour down the Sepperalky Road will soon get you a line of 20 to 30 cars backed up behind you. Then what do you do? Great!
Climb on your brakes, sir.
Good boy. Then you will listen for that musical sound of fenders crunching at the taillights. Then's the only time we go faster than 50 miles an hour. You think you know it all, don't you, Frick? Well?
On the causeway to Frenchy Airport, sir.
Right. A good blast along there, and your slipstream alone can flip a moped clean over the parapet. Which brings us to indicators. I don't want to see those little lights twinkling at all until you're at least 3/4 of the way round the turn. Then we can play bus drivers and leave them on all day. In the old days, it was enough merely to indicate one way and then turn the other. A jolly motorist is wise to this day and that. And the only way you can surprise him is by indicating and then reverse into him. Yeah. Still on indicating calm signals. I don't want to see any of this poof that dangling your arm out the window, rubbish. I want to see wild gesticulation. The man in the vehicle behind you will look to see what's going on. And where? He's off the road. Now then, what about passengers on a bridge?
Pretty things. Flowers and ferns and trees and...
My God, some others grab another on a bridge.
Hibiscuses.
Never mind, lad. We'll get you a brain transplant as soon as I can catch a cockroach for the donor. You have to treat passengers like mushrooms. Keep them in the dark and feed them bullshit. Once they're in the vehicle, it's the standard drill. No eating, no smoking, no sex, and don't slam the doors. Extra points, of course, will take you the longest possible route, and there'd better be a big tip at the end of the day, or else, altogether, the luggage goes in the ditch. Right. Well, that's about all we've got time for this evening. So good luck, good driving, and stick 'em for all you can get. Cheers from this. And hey, let's be careful out there, huh?
One step closer. That's what Belgo people say. One step closer. With our thirds every day. Build that ugly tower for you. That's what Belgo people do. Belgo. Screw. Because of all you energy-minded constellationists out there, our profits were only up 36% last year. But don't worry, you can count on us to speak with the Price Control Commission and make this year a real backbreaker. Build an ugly tower for you. That's what Belgo people do. Belgo. Screw you.
One of life's greatest rewards is an erotic experience of the highest order. combining nicely the atmosphere with a wide selection, outstanding service. The Blue House Sex Shop in Hamilton, featuring inflatable farm animals, still not included. Cabbage Patch dolls, quick release raincoats, Reagan and Mondale costumes for mass debating sessions during erection. All merchandise sold in plain brown wrappers. Your girlfriend will swear there's no other sex shop in the world like the Blue House. Well, at least not in Bermuda. As you leave the Blue House, you're already dreaming of your next night between the sheets. The Blue House Sex Shop. On Queen Street, of course.
And now, for an update on the International Alcathon, here's our roving reporter, Penelope Parker.
Good evening. This is Penelope Parker in downtown Hamilton, reporting on the International Alcathon. We're reporting live from the Prick and Tickle, where earlier this evening, the British entry dropped out of the race. At approximately 7:20, Harvey from Bristol, cream of the expatriate accountant crop, was reaching out for an Amstel extended to him by the nearby Atlantic cruise liner when he inadvertently fell off the balcony. As you can see among the surviving entrants, we have an American, God Wiser. Sam Pauli from France. And the local favorite, Brew Butterfield. For those viewers who have just tuned in, the objective of the Alcathon is to complete a full circuit of the Hamilton bars and an attempt to exceed the record limit on the Alco analyzer. We're moving on to the long tail now. Please stay with us as we'll be updating our report as this prestigious event develops. This is Penelope Parker in Hamilton, Bermuda!
Here in Hamilton, we're proud of stupid things, like big car parks which nobody uses because they're too expensive, like traffic lights conveniently placed to prevent the movement of traffic in any direction at any time, and my bank's stupid too. When I think we need an extra bedroom in the hut, or my wife tells me we need a new car.
Oh, we don't need a new car!
Shut up, woman! This is my ad!
When are we going on vacation?
We're not going on bloody vacation this year! Shut up! So come to my bank. The Bank of Butterfield. Bermuda's first bank. My bank.
No, dear, it's our bank!
If it's not your bank, it's
bloody wrong on you! Shut up and go on!
Good afternoon, Cars and Stars. This here is Bob speaking. Can I help you? Yes, sir, that's absolutely right. We here at Cars and Stars specialize in custom design and manufacture of automobiles for the rich and famous. Who have we made cars for? Well, sir, are you familiar with Dolly Parton? You like to be familiar with Dolly Parton, huh? Well, sir, for Dolly, we took a BMW and we substantially altered the front end of the vehicle. Then we went ahead and beefed up the sound system. We did the entire interior with genuine cowhide and made a few other minor adjustments. Turned out to be a real beauty of an auto. Dolly liked it so much, we went ahead and ordered another one just like it. Yes, sir, that's right. She's got a pair of real beauties, too. I take it, sir, you are interested in one of our custom design autos? That's fine. Now, shall I take the specifics of your order now? Okay, y'all go right ahead. Okay, you say you want wide wheels. Now, how wide do you want these wheels? Y'all want them as wide as we can get them, huh? Okay, all righty. Now, is your dream car a compact, a regular size, or a lucky size model? Y'all want the biggest thing we can get our hands on, okay? All right. Now, may I make a suggestion, sir? With a car of that size, you're going to have a bar with a fridge and an ice maker in the back. That's nice, but can we put on dishes? Dishes, sir? Oh, satellite dishes. Yeah, sure, we can do that for you, sir. And a video recorder? Yep, okay. How about a stereo? Y'all don't want a stereo. Y'all want a monster sound system, huh? Something audible about half a mile away? Got just the thing for you, sir. A little thing we call the Woodstock PA system. Yeah, it makes more noise than the entire population of most third world countries. It makes a hell of a lot of noise. Okay. Tinted windows? Sure. You want a light tint, medium tint, heavy tint, or a total blackout. I like your style, sir. You're going all the way. All right. Now, was there any other thing that you wanted in particular? Well, naturally, the engine will be a turbo. Okay, we got all that. How about paintwork on the exterior, sir? Y'all want a three-color job, huh? Red, green, and gold. Those your favorite colors, sir? No, but it goes down well with the youth. Okay, all right, well, we'll match the interior to that of the exterior. That won't be any problem. Now, will you be trading in your present vehicle to offset the cost of this new one we're going to build for you? Well, sure, we take trade-in. What kind of vehicle are you presently driving? A what? A Morris Marina. Sir, we deal only in cars. We don't deal in boats. Oh, that is car. I must say, I've never heard of that kind of car at all, sir. Oh, it's English. You know, I thought maybe with a name like Morris, it might have been Jewish. Oh, y'all don't have anything Jewish over there, huh? I reckon we can give you a trade-in on your arena. How will we expect payment of balance? You'll be paying by cash, personal check, U.S. Treasury zero interest bearing bonds. Sir, I don't wish to be rude, but are these bonds worth anything? Oh, you sold gold to get them, huh? I tend to think we'd rather have gold, sir. Oh, you'll discuss that with your finance minister, huh? Is that your wife, sir? Oh, it's your doctor. Oh, he's not your doctor, he's a doctor. Sometimes you wonder how he got to be a doctor at all. Well, I don't know anything about all that, sir, but I'll have to discuss it with our people. What is your name and number? Okay. Well, what I'll do is I'll get with our financial people and I'll call you back in about an hour or so. What? Oh, y'all won't be there in an hour. Well, will there be a secretary or a receptionist I can leave the message with? Oh, fine. Who shall I ask for? Ho, sir. I think you're going to have to spell that name for me. R-A-N-A. D as in dummy, E-R-A-J-A-H. Rage, nay, rock. Oh, not a rock. Sir, he sounds like a foreigner. Oh, y'all are still working on that. Well, sir, I'll call Mr. Notaringo back in about an hour. Oh, stop. Nah, dirt, rock, yeah. Okay, I'll call him back in about an hour or so with all the information. Yeah. I think we can do some business, sir. Thanks a whole heap for calling Fire from Stars. Bye now. Hey, Bobby Joe! Y'all can dust off that 57 Chevy. We got us a sucker in Bermuda.
Difference. I mean, if it really makes that much Peter Cooper there? Peter, I've seen those Italian swimsuits in your store. They're very, very brief, Peter. Very sexy. I'd like to see you in there. I bet you'd look absolutely lovely laying on some satin sheets from the Bed and Bath Shop. Oh, I can see you now. And those gleaming German eyes.
What's in store for you?
Take the sterling and the Deutschmark revenues and then buy a drugs and bump, man.
big heap of grubs, you know. Came from the dealers in Bangkok and Istanbul. Cool?
Yes, cool. Cool.
Come on. Ab. Ab. That's groovy.
Oh, man.
Not groovy, it's iry. Iry. So, gentlemen, business is concluded. Let's go get a bet, John.
And precision crafted from the finest natural materials, chair is maintenance free and long lasting. Chair has not one, not two, not three, but four, count them, four legs, all of equal length. Once you get chair, you'll wonder how you ever managed without it before. You can sit on it, you can kneel on it, you can even stand on it and change a light bulb. Try doing that with a moody. Chair is built to last. Use it as often as you like. Chair is so much fun, even the kids will want to use it. Bronco's chair is not available in any store. Not Cooper's, not this and that, not even the North Shore Mini Mall. This fabulous table accessory could be yours for only $49.99. That's only 37 cents a day. This once-in-a-lifetime offer will never be repeated. Call now. Phone 1-809-29-CHAIR. That's 1-809-29-CHAIR. Order Bronco's chair today, and for a limited time only, with no obligation, we'll send you Cushion, Bronco's aerodynamically designed enhancement for chair. Phone 1-809-29-CHAIR. St. David residents, call 1-800-555-1212, 6783-4598. 600-436-1097. Call now, supplies are limited. Operators are sitting by.
Offer volume where prohibited by law.
This is Penelope Parker welcoming you back to more live coverage on the International Alphathon. The competitors have taken Front Street by storm. They've sailed up Queen Street, blown through Port Street, and are now heading for the Disney. Here with me, standing next to the Alco Analyzer, is PCAA Holstein, who has had years of experience with his equipment. We are now awaiting the astonishing results of this contest. And it looks like a hometown boy is going to make good. Being a long shot, he wasn't even expected to finish in the first half.
This a hat?
The liquid athlete that you are seeing is none other than Brew Butterfield, Bermuda's tin man. Yes, and Brew's training for the Alphathon has been absolutely exhaustive, including an all-boys .6 pack AM routine, liquid lunches, and serious rum drinking sessions before, after, and instead of the evening meal. Yes, getting back to the competition, I'm going to ask St. Pauli a leading question. St. Pauli, can you tell us the key, the secret to your extraordinary consumption today?
Oui, madame. It is Swiss. Frog's legs. Legs raw. Legs
raw. St. Wiser, perhaps you can tell us. You think the competition here is really tight?
Tight! Yes,
the physical strain is really showing now. It's not certain how much more these athletes can take. As with all really tough competitions, they give their all. Some of them pushing themselves to the point of total collapse.
Arms are slipped, baby. As to standing up after all this run.
And yes, we could have a winner, folks. Brew has made it to the analyzer. Come on, Brew, you can do it. Yes, he's taking a deep breath. It's time. What a pity. And all he had to do was just to simply take the instrument and breathe into it like this.
Thank you.
CD time is 7:30 of Alpha Baptist Station MWK. Time now for Radio Mohawk News headlines. What do you buy the Bermudian Express card? Read the letters from the Mohawk Newsroom. Here I am. A freak storm, complete with high winds and hailstones, struck Tony Fogo's house yesterday morning. An estimated $50,000 worth of improvements were caused. Police report more breaking and entrance in St. David's, this time on Chapel of Ease Road, where five houses was robbed while the owners were in the church hall attending the neighborhood watch meeting. We'll have more news after this word from the Bermudian Express card. Hundreds of Bermudians travel every day to places like New York, Boston, Middletown, and Flats. And wherever they go, they take the Bermudian Express card with them. It's more safe than cash and is accepted everywhere. The Bermudian Express card. Just go down the road without it. And all back to the news. Disaster was narrowly averted this morning when Donald O'Connor fell down two flights of stairs with a case of Amstel. Luckily, he kept his mouth closed and didn't lose a single drop. And young Rodney Mitchell has been promoted to the head of his class in primary school. When the teacher asked him how he could buy 20 potatoes between six people, Rodney replied that he boiled them first and then mashed them. Later on with more news, plus the well and much, much more. So stay tuned to station MWK, the sound of St. Tibbs.
I bet they wouldn't have dared do that if Argentina had been invading them. I'm going live in 30 seconds.
You wish to add a pin, madam, that John Swan gave you on your last visit to Bermuda?
I suppose I better. I think it was that swallow-shaped thing. Yes, that's it. Bermuda, yes. Didn't I plant a tree there or something?
Yes, madam. Everybody does.
Sit down, madam.
Good morning, Gorms.
You by the party, party, party. Piss artists in the politics business. As Bermuda's youngest party, the PPP, look at local politics and laugh. Are you tired of dissension? Fed up with snakes in the grass? Sick of doctors? Don't despair. The party, 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 the party that wants to party, will party. On election day, you have a choice. The party, party, party promises to make sure that future royal visits are by the younger princess. That way we can all have a lump in our pockets. We will expedite the Club Med negotiations. After all, a little nudity never hurt anyone. Besides, it's about time we all came out in the open and aired our differences. And we won't talk about Bermuda's national song since it's too silly even for us. Nevertheless, and notwithstanding, party on down to those voting stations. Have a drink on us. Expose yourself. Vote PPP. The party, party, party.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hi. We're here this evening to view Nigel's new line of Tupperware for 85. It's the beachwear collection and more. First, we have Antoine. Antoine is modeling the Horseshoe Bay Ensemble. You'll notice that he has on those delightful green cotton work pants cut off just above the knee. A touch of athleticism with those sneakers. A loose-fitting blue pullover and a pretty movement for the solid-state blaster that he carries upon his shoulder. Headgear is de rigueur for 85. Oh, God, my drink. Jesus. You'll notice that it's a versatile accessory. Oh. And it can be worn on the head, on the shoulder, be used as a seat or a footrest. It's the total versatility is the watchword of this, the Horseshoe Ensemble. Let's have a nice hand for Antoine. Up next, we're still on the beach, girls. This is Lisa, and she models the outfit to wear at Shelley Bay in 85. It's an austere four-piece outfit, drab gray. It's designed to not attract admiring glances or pesky royal gazette photographers in 85. That functional policeman's raincoat is just to cover everything in case the temperatures get a trifle too high. That is something totally unobtrusive. Do you think for Shelley Bay in 85, Lisa? Thank you. Lovely. Let's have a nice hand for Lisa. Now we move to the bustling metropolis of Hamilton. And here is the fashion plate of 85. The man who's comfortable with all styles, he wears them all the time. You'll notice he has on baggy pants, pleated pants, straight leg pants. He's got them all on. Flares, the whole bit. The tops are all color coordinated. White, yellow, dingy gray. A little buff tone there. A touch of macho around the base there. That macho is back for 85, if you didn't know. That's a rugged cord belt. It holds everything together. The footwear is comfortable, functional, tough, all-weather footgear. That is the man who is comfortable with all styles. A true fashion plate, ladies and gentlemen. That's Tommy. Nice hand for Tommy. And now, for the yachting set, this is Chummy. Chummy is modeling a true, Yachting is his thing. You'll note the hat and the footwear, that's dock sides on the bottom. The classic black trench coat for him for all reasons, all seasons. Everything is there. You'll notice the functional gray trousers, perfect for all weather wear. That is a true bon vivant, that man there. That is my good man, Chummy. Chummy! Well, he'll come back, don't worry. For the young urban professional, a man who wants to make his mark on the corporate ladder, Mr. Bancroft shows us an outfit oozing with authority. It demands respect, this outfit. The accessories will make it. You'll notice the piece of stick, it puts a snap in his stride and a bump on your head. That's the thing to wear if you want to be the head of a multinational corporation in 85. That's Nigel's line for 85, ladies and gentlemen. Nice round of applause for the models, please.
Right up in there, and it all does it by itself. Right, as you see, it has now disappeared. Company must appear in the hat here. So thank you very much.
It's the best with electric headlights and genuine electric relay direction indicators on both front and back. All these features and more, an electronic push-button activated warning device, plus a lockable hand-operated motion elimination device only with Patsy. It's the best. Combine this with safety first foot-operated hydraulic braking system and pneumatic tires, and you get the best money can buy. Believe this and you're a real asshole. Get the
Good evening, everybody. Bored Hackster here with another Hackster's Book Review. And this week on the program, of course, we bought in a few books that we thought you might be interested in seeing. And the first one is this one with it's a very pretty cover that I'd like to show you, don't you think? It's called Auto Erotica, and it's by a foreign-sounding couple called Sven and Inga. And it's full of helpful and interesting tips on how you can paint and redecorate your cars. And there are over 300 beautiful color photos in this book. Well, perhaps not quite what I had in mind for you, but I'm sure you'll enjoy it anyway. The other book that we have this evening is called Lord of the Rings. Now, Lord of the Rings is a book all about the famous boxers that we've all loved to watch over the years. Boxers like Cassius Clay and Sugar Ray Leonard and also Henry Cooper and, of course, all the others. And just reading the back of the book here, here are some that I haven't heard of before. People like frogs and baggins. Well, it must be a very well-researched book, and that's the Lord of the Rings. It has a foreword and plenty of pages packed full of information. It's a shame that there are no color pictures to enhance it. Well, still a good book, so come in to Hackster's and see us for the Lord of the Rings. And really, that's just about all the time we have for this week's program. But we do invite you to come in to Hackster's and see us. We've just got a brand new shipment of the Bermuda Telephone Directory. And that book has wonderful, wonderful characters. Not much of a story, but I think you'll enjoy it anyway. So until next week, this is Ford Hackster saying so long and have a good week.
You just tuned in, you missed a wonderful early girl, and you just played a little thing called Mama Said There'll Be Days Like This. You're not especially to Lois tonight. Time now for the latest Mohawk radio news. This is latest from the Mohawk newsroom, R.I.L. Residents on Texas Road are up in arms about the bus service here in St. David's. They're complaining the drivers now will stop to pick them up. In the bus operator's defense, the Transport Control Department says it is impossible for the drivers to keep their timetables if they have to keep on stopping for passengers. Medical history is made in St. David's. Local medical genius Malcolm Peel's lab has just discovered a cure for which there is no known illness. And Melvin Fogo has just retired from the Bank of Bermuda after 25 years of dedicated service. The management expressed their gratitude at a short ceremony where they presented Melvin with a pair of gold cufflinks. He's now looking for somebody to go and get his wrist pierced. But that's it for the news. That brings the time now here on station MWK to 9 o'clock. That's 0900 on the base, and for you Marines listening in, the little hands on the 9 and the big hands on the 12. That means it's time for the latest soap opera news. So no matter whether you're a fan of As the Island Stands, St. Brendan's Hospital, All My Ace Boys, or The Young and the Worthless, stay tuned now as Tim brings us up to date with the latest soap opera news.
John tells Lois that their affair is no longer a secret, as Kenny has stolen the videotapes and threatens to show them on CNN. Due to the excitement, Lois swallows her fork and is rushed to hospital, where she meets Anne, who's Mr. Lottie, who's recovering from brain surgery. Anne confides to Lois that although she's married to Quentin, who works for the power company, she is hopelessly in love with Dr. John. Unbeknownst to them, however, Dr. John is in fact a plumber who came to fix the toilets one day, light the place, and stay. Because of his uncanny resemblance to the real Dr. John who defected to Russia, he has fooled everybody and is quietly taking a correspondence course in advanced neurosurgery. Meanwhile, Tuffy, the Crafts Dog Show champion, has been flown home, and Bobby retrieves with an aid of an enema a little plastic bag full of white powder he made the dog swallow in England. He succeeds, but his carpet will never be the same again. Sergeant Alec, who longs to shut down Bobby's profitable envelope business, is attending the suitcase murder trial, where Austin is on the verge of being acquitted, when the body of the suitcase is discovered in his wife's closet by Julian, who is reading the meter in his jockey shorts. Back at Belko's nuclear power facility, Quentin discovers that his wife has packed bologna sandwiches for the fourth consecutive day. In disgust, he hurls the lunchbox across the room, striking a vital control. As a result, all the safety interlocks are disengaged, and when Quentin flushes the toilet, the water level in the tank drops, knocking out the reactor's cooling system. Due to a computer error, the resulting total destruction of the island is seen as a Russian attack, and the Pentagon retaliates immediately. 20 minutes later, the human race is extinct. Except for the crew of a returning space shuttle, where Captain Rowley and First Mate Chummy are both more than madly in love.
Thank you, Keel. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll continue with this thrilling story next week. Time now for a word from one of our many sponsors.
Are you learning, boys? Well, get on down to the 40 and see the boys supported by the better cars and the big video with the big sound system. Free entry before 11 p.m. After that, to usual rip-off prices. And don't forget, we've got the biggest, most obnoxious barmen and pharmacists in the whole union. So get on down to the 40, remember? Sure, electricity's going off, but who gives a shit? Chances are, if you're listening to this, you're using electricity. If not, cocky little bugger, aren't you? Just think, without electricity, you wouldn't be able to absorb all the mindless, tasteless trash on TV today. Be able to watch the news coverage and how they're trying to take over the last few square inches of open space in Pembroke. Here at Bronco, we realize that we've got you by the balls, because without us, everything stops. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, without you. On a Sunday, or just plain old... Shit Creek. So leave those lights on. Leave those appliances running endlessly. And remember, the more electricity you use, the more breakdowns, the more feeble excuses, and of course, the more we'll charge the consumer. We're Belco, asking Bermuda to help us to grow.
You made Tim was rattling on, so I didn't get a chance to give you the weather before. Time now for the Radio Mohawk AccuWeather forecast. Presently, skies in St. David's are clear. But the shark wall has got a little bit of a haze on it, so I tend to think we ought to get clouding over a little sprinkle, maybe a rain heavy around about 5 o'clock or so. Right now, the winds are from the north, but I noticed that the silk spiders are building their way up on the east side of the house. So I think the wind probably shift around, come from the west, and we might have a hurricane around about midnight tonight. Especially since I ain't seen no lizards lately. Anytime you don't see no lizards for a long time, it's gonna be thunder, lightning, and all kinds of ignorance like that there. Especially since I noticed that the matchmaking you can leave over my sea rat's house was turning real red. Last time that happened, we had an earthquake and hailstones, big as watermelons, and water spouts, and things like that. It was awful. So if you're on your way home, you might want to stop into the church and say a prayer, because Armageddon is probably when you eat. That's it for the Radio Mohawk AccuWeather forecast. Oh yeah. Hey y'all, she's right on time. British Airways, coming in 3 hours late. Coming in Colorado road too. Christ, I wonder if your boat's tied on.
Easy, 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 easy
Blue grotto goldfincher. I didn't know dolphins were indigenous to these waters.
Oh yeah, they don't come from here. They were recorded years ago for Americans who didn't want to go carnal.
Hey, a Bermudan cop couldn't stop for a drink, eh?
No. Then he goes this way on the way to the airport.
What's the name of this road we're on here?
North Shore Road. As it goes along the North Shore. That there's Enterprise Russia.
What was that?
An elephant.
All these people are mopeds. Are they all natives?
You mean locals?
Yes, Bermudans.
No, look, let's get this straight once and for all. We're not natives. We're locals. It is Bermudians.
Not Bermudians. You're saying you're getting awfully close to that young lady on moped,
no? No, I'm not getting that close. I'd like to get next to her, though.
What's that thing with that sound off?
Oh, what'd you say you did for a living?
Hey, I'm an accountant, actually.
Okay, there's nothing there you want to buy.
Who was that?
I don't know. I didn't recognize your car.
Then why did you wave?
Because of me.
So why, John? might talk about all that you've gained so far and the chance you might gain more popularity by giving 18-year-olds a vote.
What?
Frankly, John, I think you're underestimating yourself.
That's right.
You've never had a strong base amongst you. And by giving 18-year-olds a vote, we'll just be handing the advantage to them.
That's right.
You see, John, they understand the wants and needs of 18-year-olds.
I understand the wants and needs of 18-year-olds.
Well, they can talk the language of 18-year-olds.
I can talk the language of 18-year-olds.
Fine, they appreciate the music and the lifestyle of 18-year-olds.
I appreciate the music and lifestyle of 18-year-olds.
No, John, they can relate to 18-year-olds.
I can relate to 18-year-olds.
That's no. right.
That's right.
No.
Is it? Yes.
No.
Yes, that's right. And for those of you who doubt me,
I do.
Listen, clap your hands, everybody, and sing along with me. And I'm Smiling John, and I am the one who runs the UVP. So you say you want a brand new car, think a trip each year, go afar. You want credit cards, diamond rings? I can give you all those things. Just vote for me. UVP, UVP, UVP! Hi, I'm John W. Swan, incredibly hip leader of the incredibly hip political party, the UVP. And I'd like to address my remarks to all 18-year-old voters out there tonight. I think you'll like what I have to say. So you want an apartment of your own with a color TV and a private phone. You want a video and a satellite dish? I can grant your every wish. You want to make money the easy way? Turn up one Friday and collect your pay and make 10:30 and knock off at 3 and have a 2-hour lunch with a martini? Well, just repeat after me. U-V-P. That's the party for me.
That's the party for me.
Everybody say UVP.
UVP.
That's the party for me.
That's the party for me.
Get down! Okay, get back up! Okay, let's get the rhythm. If you're young and white, it's all right. If you're young and brown, gather around. If you're young and black, come on back, please. If you're young or old, join the fold. Get down! Okay, let's not say we did. Okay, let's boogie. 18-year-olds like to boogie. We'll do the Harry Mirror boogie. That's where you take a giant step to the right and just stand there. So if you heard my rapid line, remember my name is our election. John W. Swan, UVP, everybody say, that's a party for me. 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 And told you would work. I know the rap will work, but just in case, Boy John! Yes! Yes! The rouge, no lipstick, I've even got a song. Come, vote for me. Vote for me. Vote for me. Come.
like the show tonight, and everybody say, all right.
All right!
Say, ho!
Ho!
You don't stop, but unfortunately we have to. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Peter Smith. My brother, Freddie Barrett. Hello, lady, Valerie Sherwood. Will Rogers. Jim Taylor. Our special guest, Ian Burch. Yours truly, Bruce Barrett. Thank you. Helping the booth doing lights is our director, Randy Lears. And also on sound is the great Apple Smith of 40 Thieves. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Chris, that's two pictures. Where?